I was born 400 years ago in the Highlands of Scotland. I am immortal, and I am not alone. Now is the time of the gathering, when the stroke of a sword will release the power of the quickening. In the end, there can be only one.
Here we are, born to be kings. We're the princes of the universe. Ah! I am immortal. I have inside me blood of kings. I have no rival. No man can be my equal. Send me to the future of you all.
Oh! White face, 6 feet tall. Weight about 170. Short hair, brown eyes. Is that about all, Mr. McCloud?
I think so.
Inspector LeBron, another homicide was reported. Prosecutor Barrett was killed half an hour ago in Marne-la-Vallée.
The jihad swore there would be retribution.
Witnesses said the killer was dressed as an acrobat in whiteface.
Just like the one that killed Judge Belson last night. Barrett lived 20 miles from here. How the hell did the killer make it all the way over here in traffic in 20 minutes?
Damn it!
This wine is inferior. Are you trying to shame me before my friends?
You'll need your wits tomorrow for the peace talks with the English. A little moderation might be in order.
Moderation is for monks, MacLeod. Smile, Duncan. You should enjoy yourself. You're only young once.
When the peace talks are over.
You worry too much. I know you're in charge of protecting my person, but this is my chateau, and no one will dare attack me here. You know each other?
We've never met before.
But I'm sure we'll meet again.
You should drink with us.
If I may.
Absinthe.
From the Lucchese family. None better in the whole of France.
No, thank you. Madness and death are not things to which I aspire.
Who wants to live forever?
I was quite the magician myself in my youth.
Really? Well then, perhaps my Lord Baron would care to join us. I'm sure your guest would enjoy that.
Baron, don't do this.
Yes, perhaps he's right. Perhaps somebody slightly younger and more supple might...
I'm young enough and strong enough for whatever you require.
Please, Baron.
Who is the lord of this manor?
Are you ready, my lord?
Always. What would you have me do?
Thank you.
I don't suppose you would be able to recognize him if you saw him again?
I might.
How could you? He was in whiteface.
Well, the color of his eyes, the shape of his nose, his face structure.
You're a very observant man.
Thank you.
Do you have a match?
No, I don't smoke.
Have we ever met?
I don't think so.
I think we have.
I only just recently returned to Paris.
Okay. We have your address if we need you.
Well, hope you catch him.
We will. Do you have a match?
No, Inspector, I don't smoke.
The Bureau of Arts hired me because they think I'm an expert on sculpture.
You are.
The only thing I feel expert in is knowing how little I really know.
Well, then you're on the true path to wisdom.
The man you saw wasn't an immortal, so why do you think Kuyler was involved?
It has to be him. It's his pattern. He hides behind costumes and makeup.
But why go through all that trouble?
Because when people see an acrobat or a clown, they laugh, they relax, they lower their guard. What better time to kill?
You've met him before.
He killed a good friend.
If he knew you were here, would he?
He's not gonna challenge me. He's an assassin, not a warrior. He kills when least expected, and he prefers his victims unarmed.
When we left the States, I had this fantasy that somehow the gathering wouldn't find us. I know. It's everywhere. I just wish...
Tessa, he doesn't know where I am. There's no reason for him to know.
What's up, Mac?
What is that?
What's that? Tessa, I'm shocked. It's Napoleon.
You hungry?
Am I? Oh, of course. Thank you. You like it? Got it down at the flea market. Had a hell of a time with it on the subway.
It's called the Metro.
The Metro, right.
Yeah.
I knew that.
Mm-hmm. What's it for?
It's for you guys. It's sort of a barge warming present.
For us?
Yeah. Well, look, I mean, if you don't like it, I...
No, it's very, very...
Historical.
Thank you. Let me see if I can find a place to put it here. I'll just move this thing out of the way.
Oh, why don't we leave everything where it is just for a while?
Oh, okay. You want to live with it for a while? I get it. Get a feel for the room. It's okay. I understand.
I really appreciate the thought.
Oh, well, you're very welcome. It's just my way of saying merci beaucoup. You know, I have a very strange feeling that Paris and I are going to be quite good for each other, if you guys know what I mean. I think it's something about the Parisians. You know, they're so very, very, very French. They carry automatic weapons.
What?
Mac, get over here. Check this out.
Call the police.
Kuyler?
Who's Kuyler?
I remember you now. Where's Kuyler?
I don't know.
But you sure as hell know who he is.
Well, you told me.
Don't play games with me. That son of a bitch was responsible for the deaths of three very brave men today.
Who were they?
The men who tried and convicted the terrorists who blew up the cafe near the Bastille.
I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Can't or won't? What are you, McCloud? Don't tell me an antique dealer. You took out one of my best men, and he never saw you coming.
Well, I didn't know he was a cop. I just saw a guy coming at me with a gun.
You thought it was Kuyler. Just like 12 years ago. I was a young cop at the time. Kuyler had just assassinated the president of one of our banks. I heard he was hiding out by the Seine.
I won't dismember you before I take your head.
Go to hell. I didn't want to miss the tour.
Is this the way you always make an entrance?
I wanted to make an impression.
You have. Bravo. You could have been hurt. There's another boat in 15 minutes.
I wanted this one.
This interruption, ladies and gentlemen. I told you Paris was full of surprises. Behind you, we have the Cathedral of Notre Dame. Construction began in 1163 and was completed in 1343. Yes. What do you want?
It was completed in 1345.
What?
Notre Dame was completed in 1345.
How do you know? I suppose you were there.
Well, no, actually, it was a little bit before my time.
Anyway, as I said, construction was completed in 1345. Three. The Seine divides Paris in two parts. This is the left bank.
How could I forget a guy who comes crashing through a glass door, rolls over the hood of my car, and disappears?
It wasn't me.
Hey, Inspector.
What were you doing there?
There's a message for you from Chief.
Your ID checks out. Fine. But who are you?
We've been through this already.
And we'll go through it again.
You have my statement and my papers. Either charge me or let me go.
If I find out that you've lied to me about Kuyler, you'll share a cell with him for the rest of your natural life.
Excellent. I think the light looks perfect just like that. What do you think?
I think it looks like it looks.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Looks pretty good. Yo, Mac, what's up?
Darius doesn't know where Kuyler is.
Well, maybe he split town after he popped those two guys.
I doubt it. No one knows what he looks like except me. He could be standing 5 feet away from LeBron and he wouldn't even know he was there.
So what are you going to do?
Find him.
Right. The CIA and the Intergalactic Space Patrol can't find him, but you, Duncan MacLeod, can. Uh-huh. What are we looking for?
Old liquor and specialty shops. Do you have any pre-1940?
If I did, I would keep it and drink it myself. I have here, boss.
No, I'll keep looking, thank you. Do you have any absinthe?
It is against the law to sell absinthe.
Well, to connoisseurs. True men of discretion. Such things can be made unimportant.
I wish I could help you.
Me too.
Who sent you here?
A friend whose tastes I share. Little taller than I am. Well built. Short hair. Oh, my friend asked me to make sure that you didn't sell me his.
Tell him I understand his need. Tuesday noon, there'll be another bottle for him. Just like always.
Good. He'll be very pleased to hear that. Thank you.
Hello?
Yeah.
That's a good way to get yourself killed, my friend. It's not funny.
I'm sorry, I think it's very funny.
Well, I hate this place. It makes me feel like I'm walking around the dead.
Why are you here?
There was a witness to the killing at the cafe.
So what? All he saw was a man hidden by a mask of makeup.
Well, the guy swears that he could identify Anthony out of his makeup. We have to get rid of him. That's not all. LeBron thinks that he could identify you.
Impossible. Everybody who knows my face either works for me or they're dead. What was the gentleman's name?
McLeod. Duncan McLeod. You know him?
Perhaps not everybody who knows my face is dead. Yet.
So what do I tell Richie?
Well, tell him the truth. Tell him you hated the sculpture and you smashed it into 1,000 pieces.
I did not. It was an accident.
You mean you didn't hate it?
Of course I hated it. Anybody with any taste would hate it. But I didn't knock it off the stand on purpose.
Well, that's not what Freud would say.
Yeah, I'm sure the two of you had hours of fascinating conversations.
Yeah, well, as a matter of fact...
What is it?
LeBron.
McLeod. Miss.
Inspector.
I've come to see if you've remembered anything about Kyla.
No, I'm sorry.
Me too. Last night, I spoke with a Sergeant Bennett in the U.S.
No, how is the Sergeant?
Still trying to figure out how you turn up in the middle of so much crap.
Well, I'm just lucky, I guess. Give me a hand. Give me a hand. Richie, call an ambulance.
What was I supposed to do? McLeod could identify me.
You acted carelessly, without orders.
I thought you'd be happy if I killed him.
But you didn't kill him. You didn't even kill the cop.
I will.
You will do nothing unless I tell you. You made a very serious mistake, Anthony. Now McLeod knows I'm onto him.
What's the big deal, huh? The guy is nothing but a bystander. I will get him next time.
Am I talking to myself? Which words didn't you understand? I said, McLeod is mine.
What? Hey, I didn't know you had something going with this guy.
Well, you know now.
I'm sorry. Look, Kuyler, you know me. You know I can make it right.
It's okay. Forget it. Now it's right.
They told me you kept me from bleeding to death.
I did what I could.
Don't expect any thanks. If you were up front with me about Kyler, this wouldn't have happened.
I didn't come here to argue with you, LeBron. I just came here to thank you and to tell you I owe you. You saved Tessa's life.
Not to mention your own.
If you need anything.
How about a new arm? The bone in mine is shattered all to hell. You know what you cost me, McLeod? You cost me my damn career. Cops with a useless arm don't make it up the ladder. It's bad for the photo opportunities. The public likes their commissioners in one piece. It makes them safer, knowing the guy in charge can fire a damn gun.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. Right. Get the hell out of here.
One of your men is owned by Kuyler.
Come again?
You heard me, Inspector.
You're a liar.
Am I? How did Kyler's man know where I lived? Did anyone else but the police know I was a witness to the shooting?
I don't buy it. You're deep into this, McLeod. And you're just trying to cover your own ass.
You've been after Kuyler for years. And why has he always been a step ahead of you?
Because people like you don't talk to me.
You're a good cop, LeBron. Think about it.
Thank you, madame. Come and see us again.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Glass? Someone might come in. I would rather you didn't drink it. I hope your friend was happy with his purchase.
What did you say?
The man you sent here.
The man I sent here?
He said he was your friend.
Oh, yes. Tall, long dark hair.
Yes, that's him.
How nice to see you, McLeod. Especially on holy ground. We've had so few opportunities to just chat.
This is not a social visit.
Incidentally, I owe you an apology. Anthony was very sloppy. I killed him for you.
You're mad, Kuyler.
Maybe. Maybe I'm just trying to excel at what I do. Didn't you ever want to be the best at something?
But it means nothing to you?
On the contrary. It means everything. I would have thought you'd have understood me better than that. I was never very good at anything else. As a kid, there was always someone faster or smarter. Did you know I have a very pleasant singing voice? It's good, but not good enough for grand opera. It's the same with my tumbling.
So you kill?
We all have to do something. Besides, it pays well. And I have expensive habits. Do you know how many mortals I've killed over the years?
I'm sure you do.
I've kept a book. 2,760. Now, I don't want you to think I'm bragging, but I'm the greatest assassin in all of history. Of course, there have been men responsible for more deaths, but none of them killed so many, so close.
I don't think there are going to be any more entries in your book.
I think I'll have a few more trophies on the wall before I retire.
Let's go.
Don't think so. See that man over there? He's got an automatic pistol in his jacket. One word from me and,
my point. I knew you would.
I'll find you.
Correction. I'll find you first.
I had him. He stood right next to me. I could have just reached out and...
Do you believe his men would have killed those children?
Absolutely.
Then what other choice did you have?
I don't know. Maybe I...
Duncan, you may be immortal, but you're not omnipotent. You couldn't save that Baron. You couldn't save LeBron's arm. The world is not your responsibility.
Kyla has no remorse whatsoever. He kills just to gratify his own ego. He's still out there. I don't know where to begin to look. But... What are you doing?
I'll call and cancel the meeting.
No. The first presentation to your board is not something you want to cancel.
Duncan.
Go. You have your job to do, I have mine. This is our life, Tessa. We have to keep living it.
I know.
Kyler's killed again.
Who was it?
The body has not been identified yet. It was found in a warehouse. In the garment center.
Are you sure it was Kyler?
Well, Inspector LeBron is. He wants to see you.
Oh. How's he feeling?
He checked himself out of the hospital against doctor's orders.
You know, some guys are gluttons for punishment. Well, you know, I'm surprised that LeBron hasn't caught Kyler by now, aren't you?
He's an elusive bastard, that's for sure.
Yeah, the way he drinks, you'd think he'd make a mistake by now.
Or the absinthe would kill him.
Maybe the police would drink a little more. Maybe they'd understand him better.
I think we should go.
Okay. I'll just get my coat. He's in there?
He's waiting for you here.
Well, you can go now. You've done your master's bidding. It was the absinthe.
Well,
get it. Thank you.
I took care of this.
How are you feeling, Inspector?
Lousy. Get out of the car, Saul.
Something wrong?
Just get your ass out of the car and keep your hands where I can see them.
Sure, Inspector. Whatever you say. What is this all about?
Where did you take McCloud?
What makes you think I took him anywhere?
Because I put a radio transmitter in your damn car, you lying son of a bitch. Why did you sell out? Was it only for the money we found in the Swiss account?
Inspector, whatever you think, I assure you I can explain everything.
You're going to do life, Saul. And I'm going to see to it personally. Where is McCloud? Come on!
So you did find me after all.
Oh.
It's just me and you. And there's nowhere to go.
Get on with it then.
What's the big hurry to die? Huh? You know, I never told you before, but I've missed you all these years. On for the road. I so hate to drink alone. Now I can finish what I started all those years ago.
Well, I think it's going to be a little different this time.
Well, really? Why's that?
I forgot to mention. I brought this.
And I thought you were just another pretty face.
McCloud! McCloud, you in there? McCloud!
Inspector LeBrun, what are you doing here this evening?
What happened at the garment factory?
What garment factory?
With Kuyler.
Oh, you still insist that I know him.
Know him? You decapitated him.
Oh, when did I do that?
Tonight. Saul took you there on Kuyler's orders.
Good evening.
And why would he want to do something like that?
Because you were right. Kuyler owned him.
Oh, so Saul's been lying to you all this time?
Yes.
But you still believe him about this? Thanks, William.
You won't admit to any part of this, will you?
How could I?
And I guess, according to you, he's been here all evening.
You wouldn't want me to lie, would you?
I'll show you out, Inspector.
I can't prove anything, but we both know what happened.
Goodbye, Inspector.
Not goodbye. Au revoir. It's my guess I'll be seeing you again.
Cheers.